Now I will demonstrate GlobePharma's MiniBlend powder blender. Before moving on to actual demonstration of the machine, I would like to discuss the features of this machine briefly. This machine was designed to blend powders in small quantities. You can blend as small as 5 grams or even 2 grams of the material, or you can go up to 1 kilogram using V-shells. This blender accommodates a bottle blending attachment, which is already installed on this machine. The bottle blending attachment can accept 3 different containers on it. They can be glass bottles, plastic bottles, or small vials. And you can mix quantities from maybe 2 grams all the way up to like maybe 50 grams, depending on the size of the bottle or vial you're using on the bottle blending attachment. The second attachment that can go on here is a V-shell. There are 3 different sizes of V-shells that can be accommodated by this machine. The half quart, where you can make 250 grams of blend, 1 quart, where you can make about 1/2 kilo of blend, and the largest one is 2 quart, where you can make up to 1 kilogram of the blend. This machine has a safety guard, which when it is raised, the machine will stop running. It is a safety feature. And it has a timer where you can set the time of blending. It has a reset function where you can reset the time, and there is a lock function. Once you set the time, you can press that lock button and it will lock the blending time. So accidentally you don't change the blending time. It has a start button and it has a stop button. But if you press both buttons together, you can actually jog the blender, which means if you have a V-shell, you want to stop it in a particular position, then you can press both buttons and it will jog to this position, and then you can stop. Now I will show you how to use the bottle blending attachment followed by the V-shells to make small powder blends on the MiniBlend powder blender. This is the polycarbonate safety enclosure. In order to lift that, we have to remove the 2 pins. There is one on the right side, and there is another on the left side. You just pull the pins outside, and then lift the guard up, and then you can lock it in position using the same locking pins. Just insert one pin here on this side and the other pin on the other side. This is the bottle blending attachment, which is attached to the drive shaft by means of a small bolt here. The bottle blending attachment has 3 bottles or vials here. Let me just take one bottle out, and I will put microcrystalline cellulose powder in it and a little bit color, and then we will mix it, and you can see after the mixing is finished how the blend looks. And this is the color I'm going to use. I will put a little bit of that in this microcrystalline cellulose powder. Close the cap, and we will put it back on the bottle blending attachment. And this is how it looks before it is mixed. Now the bottle goes back here. You tighten the screw, and the screw has a plastic piece here that actually puts pressure on the bottle cap. Now it is ready to be mixed. Now we will close the safety guard, set the timer, and start the blender. We pull the safety locking pins on both sides of the guard. Then slowly drop the guard in the closed position. Switch the power on the button as I showed before. It is in the back of the machine. Set the timer by pressing up or down arrows. I will set the blender for 5 minutes, and I will lock the timer in place. So now it is set for 5 minutes and it is locked. Now we are ready to start the blender. As the bottle blending attachment is turning, you can see that each bottle mimics the movement or action of a V-shell because of the angle at which the bottle is situated on the bottle blending attachment. That angle at which the bottle is situated is similar to the angle of a V-shell. And you can also see how well it is already mixing in the bottle. We will show you after the 5 minutes run how uniform the blend looks. The timer also displays the elapsed time. For example, right now it is 4 minutes and 44 seconds, so 16 seconds are left to complete the 5 minute blending time, which we set. We will now open the safety enclosure to remove the bottle and look at the blend and see how uniform the blend is. Open the locking pins on both sides, lift the guard up, put the locking pins back, and remove the bottle. And this is the blend we have made. Let me show you how to remove the bottle blending attachment and install a V-shell, any one of these. There is a bolt here, which we just use a wrench to remove the bolt. This just comes off, and then we will take one of the shells, remove the bolt on the trunnion of the shell, insert the shell on the drive shaft. You can use your fingers to pretty much tighten the bolt again, and then use the wrench to tighten that. You need a different wrench. It is tight now. Let me show you how to charge the powder in the V-shell. In order to do that, we have to open one of the two cover plates of the V-shell. Each cover plate is locked in place on the shell by means of two thumb nuts. Each thumb nut can be loosened using this tool. The pin on one end of this tool will go into the four holes on each thumb nut, and you can just turn it to open the thumb nuts. Once they're loose enough, you can actually use your hand to remove the thumb nuts. Once they're removed, just using this knob, you pull the cover plate completely out. As you notice, each cover plate has a gasket here. It is made of FDA-approved white nitrile or FDA-approved white neoprene rubber. This gasket can be removed completely for washing purposes. And to install the gasket, you just install it around the edge of the cover plate, and it is kind of tight, which it is supposed to be. Now we can load the powder into the shell. Now the cover plate will go back on, and you fasten the two thumb nuts back on the cover plate. Most of the time, you may be able to tighten the thumb nuts just with your hands. Otherwise, you can definitely use the tool again. And we will start the blender just like we did last time. We will set the timer. And then we will start the blender. Once the blender stops, we will remove the V-shell and discharge the blend into whatever container or a plastic bag you would like to hold the blend in. If the blender stopped in a position where you cannot discharge the blend, you can jog the shell until you come to that discharge position. You just like that, you can stop it in a discharge position, then remove the bottom closure of the shell and discharge the blend. Now the blending is done. We will open the guard and discharge the powder blend. This is the discharge shaft that holds the discharge cover plate in place and tight to prevent any leakage of the powder during blending. Now this tool, we will use the other end where it has a hole there which can go on the pin of the discharge shaft. You can turn it 90 degrees, and now the discharge plate is loosened, so you just pull it out, and the powder actually discharges into the bottle. The main switch must be turned off and electrical cord unplugged before cleaning or working on the machine. High voltage. Although this machine works on 110 volts or 220 volts, you should be careful not to touch any of the exposed wires or anything like that, so you should be careful with the voltage always. Improper use may cause injury. Improper use may cause injury. Warning, do not process flammable, explosive, toxic, or otherwise hazardous materials without first performing an appropriate hazard analysis. GlobePharma cannot be an expert in the chemical and biological properties of the infinite number of materials that could be processed on this machine. As sold by GlobePharma, this machine is not designed to safely process hazardous materials that are or can react to become flammable, explosive, toxic, or otherwise hazardous. The user must perform a thorough hazard analysis and risk assessment of the entire process and determine the best way to deal with the hazard identified, including contingency plans for dealing with processing errors and upset conditions. This is the power connection. The cord is connected here. This is the on-off switch, and this works on 110 volt AC, this particular machine. It can also be connected to 220 volts AC. So you should be careful when you are plugging the cord in so that you do not get an electrical shock. This one here is the overload protection fuse. If it blows off, then you just press this button to reset that.